our exposure to the broad range of topics of research was really enlightening. And what was very different here is our ability to interact and engage with the researchers. And that gave us a lot of, while they are presenting their data, we could introspect and see how it applies to us back home. And I think that was the most enriching part of this.
It's been a wonderful treat, I must say. And as policymakers, these kind of inputs, what is happening in the world, especially some papers in the context of India as well, that has been quite an eye-opener. And I think that will be the major takeaway as to what is happening and how we can use these tools to try and transform some things back home in India.
These 4 days have been truly very productive on a whole range of issues. I got to know the state of art research that is going on in this great institution, this university. So this will shape or influence my thinking on these subjects when it comes to its application to India.
A lot of relevant topics were covered, a lot of presentations which have made lasting impacts on us. I mean, I was really impressed. I'm really impressed with the work EPIC is doing as far as tracking environment and effect of pollution and polluted air on the health quality and life expectancy, etc. This is groundbreaking work that is getting done by EPIC. I don't think anybody else is doing this anywhere in the world. A lot of work that EPIC is doing in leadership of Michael Greenstone is very relevant to the issues there on the ground, and is highly impactful. And I hope that together we can hope to work towards changing the world for better. This particular 4-day program is, in my opinion, a starting point for what could be a long-lasting relationship.
I think it's been a very broadening experience for people like us who are focused on a variety of problems in India. And it helps us understand the data and the use of data behind making policy decisions. I think it's a fantastic program. I think this program needs to be carried on in the future and to try and get as many MPs as possible to come along. I think it's a good exposure for MPs, and I'm sure the interaction with MPs from different quarters of India would greatly benefit even the researchers.